Hi, I'm Merlin Tuttle, and I'm here to photograph one of our planet's most spectacular wildlife events. Looks like it's about to get going. I better hurry.
These are straw-colored fruit bats, 10 million of them. Their loss could threaten the health of human economies and whole ecosystems across Africa. Kasanka is a stopover site, critical to the survival of the world's largest mammal migration.
Wow, look at all these bats. Incredible.
Their nearly 1 meter wingspans have carried them thousands of kilometers to get here, where each night, from October to December, they take to the sky in search of fruit. Each bat consumes up to twice its body weight nightly, dropping countless seeds across the landscape. Every seed dropped is a potential new tree. But now it's the morning, and they're seeking shelter in the bat forest. Their huge numbers attract predators who are also looking for a meal. But eagles are not the biggest threat to the straw-colored fruit bats. By far, their greatest risk comes from humans.
These bats' contributions to a healthy environment are enormous, almost as large as their appetites. Yet they face serious challenges, and they need our help to survive.
Kasanka National Park is designed around the Kasanka and Musola rivers. They feed the park and the wetland habitats. It's situated in the game management area, which has some development allowed, but then it has a buffer zone which there's no development allowed at all, and it's to buffer the park from the developed areas. The bat forest itself is a Mishutu forest, which is a swamp forest.
This beautiful habitat is cooled by the nearby river. Outside the park boundaries, fruit-laden forests are also essential to provide food for these bats. The combination must be protected.
So the biggest threat is deforestation. In this area, it's mainly for agriculture.
Thousands of hectares of pristine forests have already been cleared to support an illegal game park and industrial agriculture.
This electric fence encroaches illegally on Kasanka Park, severing connected habitat and restricting natural movement of wildlife. Additionally, developers have illegally pumped water from the Luwombwa River for irrigation without the required permits, regardless of the impact on the park ecosystems and surrounding communities.
The community benefit direct from the park, one, through employment. Secondly, a revenue that comes from the park goes back to the community. It improves the rural economy and also the living standards of people. If we cut trees, we are not going to have bats coming here because there will be no foraging area. And the money that comes from this park through tourism won't be there. Everyone will be affected.
I'm Warren Mwape. I'm working in Kasanka for 9 years. Rekhaguru. Vale onaula sana emiti. Then emiti ratwafisha ko umwela no kuikata ku mfula then ngabachita ama desert abapanga desert kuno mfula tukala shota then na chipo chikengira sana mu munochalo cheso cha Zambia na ngwiro ine community yeso tapava na safari ne tapava ne futu tuchitakaita pa shari ambano kushupe mpia sha kukombwera muna ma fertilizer no bwika shibwali chinja kuli bali abashayengira ku nchi tano. So a petro tule romba kufina kutira na kulire so kwa wate Kasanka nga ya pusu kwa nishina yifu tuka safari.
At the end of the day, in Kasanka, the colony of fruit bats stretch their wings and prepare for their emergence. Visitors from around the world gather to enjoy the spectacle.
Imagine if there was a human that every single day of its life was going out and dispersing seeds and planting forests. That person would be getting a Nobel Award for conservation. And these bats do it night after night, millions of times within their lifetime.
Oh, look at them. Yeah, now they're starting to move. These straw-colored fruit bats are key contributors to the health of an entire planet we all must share. Please help protect Kasanka National Park and its vital bat.